Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Suka Alfire, and today I'm going to be talking about how to avoid getting red trust factor and some other misconceptions you might have about trust factor in general. So if you enjoyed this video and you're new to the channel, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more CSGO videos. But for now, let's get right into it. Before we get into what you can do to actually fix your trust factor if it's red, let's first go over what could have happened for it to get there in the first place so it doesn't happen to you again. All of these reasons come directly from the patch notes of when trust factor was initially added into CSGO, and I'll link the entire blog post in the description if you guys want to read it word for word for yourselves. But I'm pretty much going to be going over what I think is all the important stuff, starting with CSGO devs stating, in general, we're looking at your past experience in CSGO and on Steam to ensure the system is as accurate as possible. Of course, CSGO devs always have to give a bit of a cryptic answer when it comes to things like this, so we're going to have to do a bit of inferring. When it comes to talking about looking at past experiences on Steam, I'm just going to assume they're talking about VAC and game bans, which would make sense as if you cheated in another game, there's probably a higher chance that you cheat in CS as well. As for your past experience on Steam, I guess it would be how old your account is, and overall just looking at if your account looks legitimate. Steam level might play a bit into this, but I don't think it's that big of a factor. If you've been playing for a while, this shouldn't be a big issue, and I assume they just do this to discourage players to smurf, as if the system works properly, they should just be placed against accounts similar to theirs. And as someone who used to play on a brand new silver account with only CSGO on it and always got placed against newer accounts and extremely sketchy players, I can say I think it's working as intended. But considering most of the people saying that their trust factor is red are usually on their main accounts, this doesn't really seem to be the main issue. Now, with that being said, later on in the notes, they state that, objectively, we can tell that Prime is successful when players stick to their matches and report and kick each other a bit less. So it seems like simply playing the game and avoid being toxic, whether it's verbally, griefing, or whatever it may be, is one of the main ways to avoid your trust factor from going red. Obviously, you can't do anything about enemies reporting you if you hit a sketchy shot or something like that, but just not being toxic once again just seems like the best way to avoid destroying your trust factor, and personally, I feel like the recent updates that involve text filtering reinforce that even more and prove that CSGO devs really don't want the game to be that toxic. So now, before we get into what can fix your trust factor, CSGO devs also left an email address that you could use to send your Steam ID and a description of your trust factor experience if you feel like something's wrong. Personally, I'd spend maybe a few weeks playing MM games and not abandoning, getting kicked, or anything like that before emailing them, because I really don't know what they would do to help you, if anything, because at the end of the day, once again, it is CSGO devs, and they're crazy, man, who knows what they're gonna do. But maybe it's worth a try in the end if you feel like nothing's working. In the patch notes, it also states that the more you play, the more information the system has and the easier it will be for the system to determine who you should be matched up against. So once again, just playing a lot seems to be the best option. Also, keep in mind that if you're playing with friends that have a low trust factor, you're automatically matched up against players that have the same low trust factor as them. So if your friends have low trust factor, it's another thing that is going to negatively influence your games, and it might just not be your fault. So trying to solo queue and seeing if you get the same types of people in your games might also be another way to see just where your trust factor is at and if you need to improve it. Now, with all that being said, let me talk about some things that I think might be misconstrued with trust factor. First of all, getting commended. The option to commend people in CS has always been a thing, and based on what I've seen, with people botting insane amounts of commends, it really doesn't seem to do anything at all. In fact, it honestly might even lower your trust factor, as I feel like a lot of the profiles I check when smurfing in Silver or Gold Nova with my in real life friends tend to just have botted commends. So I would heavily advise not to bot commends at all, as it really doesn't seem to have any positive effect, if any effect at all. The same thing goes with buying accounts on Steam. Like, if you want to buy a 10-year-old account just so it seems trustworthy because of how long it's been around, I've had the same experiences with them. Like, they're always in low trust factor. And it makes sense, because CSGO devs heavily advised against this in the patch notes, flat out stating not to get accounts from other people and that they will have low trust factor. So once again, just try to be patient, don't be toxic, don't get kicked and your trust factor should improve over time. But yeah, just note that it is probably going to take maybe a while for your trust factor to fix, as it probably took some time for it to go down as well. So don't feel like you need to email them right away. Just take your time, see if it changes at all, and then you could email them as sort of a last resort, I guess. And another thing people tend to misconstrue with Trust Factor is spending time playing CS and other games on Steam and whether it helps your Trust Factor or not. Well, it's pretty much impossible to know an exact answer to that, and a lot of people have differing opinions when it comes to it. So if it isn't in the blog post, it's not confirmed at all, and you shouldn't really rely on what people are saying, as they aren't gonna have inside information, as I guess CSGO devs just don't like giving away their secrets. Just focus on what's said in this video, which is pretty much everything on the blog post, and hopefully your trust factor will improve over time. And if not, of course you can always email the CSGO devs and see if they do anything about it. But besides that, that does pretty much wrap it up for this video, so thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, but for now, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.